What does the signing of Gunnar Kiel mean for Notre Dame? It means that they're still relevant nationally. Though they haven't been in the national title picture in almost two decades, they still sell out games anywhere they play. They open next season at Dublin, Ireland. They finish the season in Los Angeles against Southern Cal. In the middle of the season, they play Miami at Soldier Field in Chicago. All of those will be sold out. They just sold out the Champ Sports Bowl against Florida State. They can recruit nationally. They still have a national appeal. They're on national TV for every single game. And they have as good of facilities as any program. What's interesting about the job that Brian Kelly has done since he came to South Bend is he inherited a program that usually had a strong quarterback. In the case of Jimmy Clausen, he was drafted in the second round of the NFL draft. But the defense is what lacked. And now it's just the opposite. Brian Kelly has remedied the defensive problems, but he can't find a quarterback to play. What Gunnar Kiel brings to the mix now is a pro-style quarterback, something that Notre Dame doesn't have at this point in time. Tommy Rees doesn't have the strong arm that Gunnar Kiel has. He doesn't have as much mobility as Gunnar Kiel has. Plus, Tommy Rees, all the assets that he brought to the table that he was known for, the moxie, the maturity, those have all gone by the wayside, and he's had trouble with ball security, throwing crucial interceptions against Florida State and Stanford. Andrew Hendricks brings great mobility and a strong arm, both better assets than what Tommy Rees has, but he doesn't have the experience. Rees was always known for his maturity and moxie and the fact that he won games. Somehow he won them. He wasn't as mobile as many quarterbacks. He didn't have the strong arm. He wasn't as big as many quarterbacks, but somehow he managed to win games, took care of the ball, didn't hurt his team. Well, now he's gotten to the point where he's not taking care of the ball. He's throwing crucial interceptions. And Gunnar Kiel's arrival signals the end of Tommy Rees's tenure as a starting quarterback at Notre Dame. Perhaps not because of Gunnar Kiel per se, but because Brian Kelly has other options in Andrew Hendricks, Everett Golson, and Gunnar Kiel to look at rather than Tommy Rees. So if Andrew Hendricks is going to be the starter and he plays poorly, he now has Everett Golson, who has been in the system for a whole year, a whole calendar year, and Gunnar Kiel that he can turn to rather than go back and forth between Rees and Hendricks. Everett Golson will be an interesting candidate to watch this spring. He hasn't gotten any game action, so he maintains that fifth year of eligibility if needed, but he's been here for an entire calendar year and learning the offense, getting reps with the scout team, and now he's going to get reps with the first and second units and really be thrown to the fire. And Gunnar Kiel brings a big, strong body, a pro-style quarterback, strong arm, good mobility, not maybe as well as Golson and Hendricks, but very good mobility as well, much better than Tommy Rees. Concerned with the waffling of Gunnar Kiel. This is a kid that in 2011 said Alabama and Oklahoma were his leading choices. Then he verbally committed to Indiana. Then he reneged on that and verbally committed to LSU, was supposed to show up to Baton Rouge on Monday and didn't, ended up in South. Is that a concern? Yes, it's a little bit of a concern, but at the end of the day, you have to remember that Gunnar Kiel is a teenager, and teenagers change their mind. And he had a lot of pressure put on him by a lot of adults at a lot of different football programs to pick them. And so that's a difficult... But you do have to wonder, a kid that wanted to go to LSU, and the first time that there's snow squalls in South Bend, or the first time that he's third string on the depth chart, or even fourth string on the depth chart, things aren't going his way. This is a kid that picked two other schools before he picked Notre Dame, and also said that two others, not including the two he picked, were leaders for his services. Is Gunnar Kiel the savior? I wouldn't go there, Notre Dame fans. You need to look no further than Dane Crist, who came out of high school, a highly heralded recruit. A lot of people thought he was going to be a great player at Notre Dame, and for a number of reasons, it just never panned out. A little bit of injury, a little bit of bad luck, a little bit of bad timing, little bit of bad throws. All of those things ended up culminating in Dane Crist finishing his career at Kansas, helping Charlie Weiss resurrect the Jayhawk program. So Gunnar Kiel very well may be the great quarterback everybody projects him to be, but you have to give him time, be patient, and let him grow. This spring is going to be unbelievable to watch the competition of the quarterback position unfold. It's going to be a topic of daily conversation with the media, just like it was in training camp between Tommy Rees and Dane Crist, only you're going to have that multiplied by two this time, with four quarterbacks being legitimate candidates to be the starting quarterback.